Everybody say, nah. tour so far. Thank you so much. I appreciate y'all. How many of you are here seeing Extreme for the first time tonight? Where the fuck have you been? You've been busy for like 38 years? You had about like a couple hours out of your day? I'm just fucking with you. It actually makes us so fucking happy that we have a new audience here tonight as well. Thank you so much for joining us. How many of you were back with us back in the 1900s? We're here, sorry. Love it. Well, maybe, nah, that's bullshit. Too young. Wasn't even born yet. What the fuck? Yeah, everybody was here when we played for three people in the club. I remember that. But honestly, man, thank you for coming back again. It actually hurt us to pull up at this venue and actually start loading in. And we were in here and then being told that we could not perform that night. It fucking ripped our hearts up because we knew that all of you were on your way here. People were flying in. Our apologies. Sorry about it. But fuck that. We're going to blow the roof up this fucking place tonight. Thank you for coming back. Anyways, it means so much to us. We do not take it for granted. Listen, for you who don't know, Porno Graffiti was not our first album. It was an album before that, self-titled album called Extreme, because for some reason it was cool just to call your album the name of your band back then. For some reason, Van Halen did it, so we said, what the fuck, let's go, come on, man. We're gonna take you down memory lane a little bit, if that's okay, do a little medley for you. I know Extreme takes like basically between 31 and 33 years to make an album. or at least fucking release one. And we apologize for that. We gotta get our shit together, you know, dysfunctional family. Little 4K, please. Anyways, one thing we wanna tell y'all, you know, one of those reasons is ever since we were like 17, 18, a long, long time ago, a galaxy far, far away, we said to each other, we never wanna release anything just for the sake of fucking releasing it. You know, with that, it has to mean something to us before it can ever mean something to you. So we're really hard on ourselves. Having said that, we went into this album, we were excited, you know, we're in our own shell. We do it for ourselves, every fucking hi-hat, every note, everything's gotta mean something to us. But one of the things that we didn't expect, because we kind of, when you do that, you shouldn't really care what anybody else thinks. But we had no idea that a bunch of 50-somethings, 60-somethings, and the 47-year-old. Give it up for K-Fig, the 47-year-old child. We had no business and no idea that we were gonna get the kind of response and the kind of love we have for this album, these songs. Thank you. We thank you so much. We are in shock still to this day. Thank you so much, man. We cannot do these shows without you. Show sold out tonight. Most of them have been sold out. We are humbled. We have no idea what the fuck is going on, but we'll take it. Gladly take it. Thank you for your kindness. We don't take you for granted. Having said that, man, is it okay if we do a new song for you off the album? Is that all right? I almost forgot the most important part. I got a bit of a wardrobe change, man. I definitely paid too much for this fucking hat. I think I got rid of it. Nah, man, I when I went to Nashville the first time, I was like, man, I heard this local shop that made shit handmade, local, and where the fuck else are gonna get a cool hat out of Nashville? I walk into this place and I told this guy, I've waited like 30 years to get your fucking hat. He said, there's a hat that's been waiting for you for 30 years. I go, really? He's like, yeah, man. It's like it's fucking handmade, it's got this exotic fucking fabric, you know, a feather from some extinct bird, I don't know what the fuck's going on with it. But, he was like, $7,000. I'm not fucking stupid, so I bought it. I'm not gonna pass up that fucking opportunity, man. Anyways, next day I'm walking down, you know, in Nashville trying to hang at all the bars and shit, be as cool as fuck, and then I was like, yeah, man, it's the same fucking hat. There goes another one right there. Anyways, God bless America. That's what that's saying. And I do mean it. It's not very cool to say these things, but God bless this country of ours, the United States of America. Give it up!
Thank you.
It's Valentine's Day, no? A lot of amazing couples out there. See, that goes out to my love of my life. Most beautiful woman in the world and a great mama. Christina, this is for you. All you, Denver, come on.
It's not that I want you not to say, but if you only knew how easy it would be to show me how you feel. More than words is all.
Beautiful. That's why we started the band together.
Birds are gonna fly.